Stacy's. This is kind of an even matchup, and I'd say even volatile, because Mario can really blow up Spacey's.
Yes.
His combo game on them is lethal.
I actually had the opportunity to, I can't remember if it was, I think it was Mario versus Fox. I think it was Light versus Anti a bit earlier, actually. But I was talking about how typically when you see these characters, these are very good characters.
Yeah, these are.
But they suffer at the hands of Distroids, which are quite common. So when you have both of them here, actually, because they're so close range, you actually see a lot of boxing and a lot of up-close game and a lot of combo potential for this one. I do think Wolf can run away with it because he does have a little bit more reach. He's got a little bit power behind his paws, but you can still see something come out from Mario, especially with Anti, who is no slouch in this game.
I think what's going to be big for Anti here is offstage kills, mostly. I feel like he's not really going to, unless he gets a catches a jump from Stock Taker, which could be good. Up smash, he's been catching a lot of people with up smash today, and Spacey's love to jump. So we're going to see probably a lot of that.
Ooh. Speaking of trying to catch a jump, trying to look for something there with the up smash, but no such luck. Reverse. I've never seen the cape into ledge grab. That's actually pretty neat.
That F tilt. Okay, so he did like three F tilts in the wrong direction, but I like that option a lot. It keeps you just out of range of Mario's up smash. Mm-hmm. So it's a really safe poking tool.
Yes, absolutely.
And, up there, yeah, there you go. Nicked off jumping.
Sometimes you just need to give him the head, you know?
Yeah, well, we'll be seeing a lot of sloppy toppy definitely from Mario this set. Onto the fog, up to Wolf, I should say.
Yo, actually gets him with the fireball, takes his jump, that's
dead.
It! Zero to death!
That's awesome, Big. Yeah, that recovery can be caped since Wolf has like a little bit of a baby stall before he starts moving on it.
He waits there a little bit. Still hasn't even taken the top stock at 187. So, not to say that this is unwinnable because Wolf has quite the power behind
it.
Yeah,
for sure.
But one stock behind, a full stock behind at that. Difficult place to come back against Anti here.
Wolf's combo game is really nasty, too, especially against Mario. Mario's that pretty good weight for most of Wolf's combos to work at the early percentages.
Yeah, early percentages and mid percentages are really good for Wolf, and then by the time you get out of those combo percentages, it's time for the straight hits, back air, forward air, oh, I'm going to grab you into the back throw, etc.
That was a weird air dodge. That scared me a little. All right, so now, yeah, Stock Taker just looking for this tipper back air right here.
Excellent
pivot grab right
I'm
there to catch the landing.
I'm surprised he didn't graze the fireball on that.
Yeah, I know.
It looked like he was.
It's really weird. The fireball can be kind of finicky sometimes, whether it wants to hit or not. Mm-hmm. All right, good down tilt. Yeah, that was a great poking tool right there. Yeah, he's just trying to be careful and not over-approach. He knows that if he takes the air, Anti's going to up smash him.
Yes. You can't take the air too much. But remember that if you're playing grounded, that's easy distance for Mario to scope out with his fireball, space out with his back air. And although Wolf can outspace him, if he gets a stray hit on him, Wolf is light, so he will die for it. All right. Oh!
Yeah.
Yo!
That was a read.
That was... I don't have words for that.
That was a great roll read. He was pressuring so well at the corner and forced him to go back on stage. And immediately when Stock Taker picked the panic option,
yes,
he just ran up on him.
No, but here's the thing, right? About that read, normally when people say, oh, yo, that was a hard read, there's like some ambiguity. Maybe there's like, oh, maybe he had a guess in mind.
It was like a pressure read.
Maybe that was hard. There is no denying. He rolled behind him and he was like, you're going to be afraid of my back throw. I'm going to run up, follow your roll, and up smash you.
Think about Wolf. Wolf's roll length isn't the greatest. So, and Mario's initial dash speed isn't that bad either. So you can really just get that up smash out there as quickly as possible. And the up smash encompasses a lot of space, too.
It does. Absolutely. He's got that, you know, not a whole lot of characters have it now. I know earlier on it was more prevalent. But he has that limb inflation thing that happens with his head where it just gets bigger while the hitbox is out, which makes it very deceptive. You think, oh, Mario, you know, he's cartoony, but he doesn't have that big.
Yeah.
So actually very safe option to get away right there. A little awkward on both of their shields, so he does an out-of-shield up air. Safe, probably wouldn't get any conversions out of it. Is he dead? Oh my god!
That was such a great reel back there. Yeah, Wolf's F-Smash is very similar to Mario's, where he reels back before it, so it's very, very hard to catch him and stuff him out on it.
Yes.
Because he literally shifts his entire hurtbox backwards.
Difficult to stuff, and then difficult to punish if you're not prepared for it.
Oh, for real. It has like very minimal end lag as well, so.
So here's the thing. Early on in the game, I don't know if this has changed. I actually labbed that out of curiosity. If you do not do like a jump out of shield or an up-y or something out of shield, it is even on shield. If you jump out of shield, it's -4 or so.
I like how he waited till the very, very last second to jump right there. Because if he got caught running his jump early off the flood, that puts Anti in a lot better of a position to gimp him.
Absolutely. And you know, that chase right there, that was looking really Spacey's-like itself. Just going like, eh, I'm going to go run up smash.
All right, so Anti's got no jump. Okay, making it back to stage. Stock Taker just going for the dash attack right there to catch the neutral get up. Excellent options like right there.
Yeah.
Ooh, he's trying to end it now, bro. He wants it done with.
you. Don't blame him, although he's offstage against Wolf right now. He's got to get back against his ledge game, which is easier said than done.
He hasn't been getting any of these tipper back airs. They've all been sour spots. He's been kind of prolonging anti-stock. The thing is, though, Stock Ticker really hasn't been hit in a really relatively long amount of time. That being said, though, here it comes. Wow.
Oh, yep.
He snuck
that
up air.
That's not a true combo.
No, it's not. And he got him for it.
Absolutely.
Stock Taker, quite the opposite of his namesake, honestly. Like, he can take stocks pretty well, also.
Oh, he's not going
to. Oh, I thought he could have made that. Wow, that was crazy. Yeah, no, Wolf ain't that good.
That was a good angle. That was a very solid attempt at that, but Wolf does not have that kind of distance on him.
With Stock's discipline and neutral, he's able to hang on to these stocks. He's also stock holder 69. Like, my man holds on to stocks for so long. Mm-hmm.
And that's honestly the thing that he needs to do when he has a lead. Although now that he's playing on even footing, Anti coming in with these combos, trying to rack up the percent and get the advantage into his field.
Oh, whiffing the grab right there. This is going to be big damage for... Okay, not committing to the up B too high. I definitely agree with that. If you commit way too high, Wolf is a fast faller, so he's going to be able to get back to the ground way before you do.
Yep.
Oh.
Waters him off. Nice. Tries to cover with the jab. Not super strong of an option because of the re-hit rate, but it is an option that covers and gets a shield. Gets him back on stage.
I notice that Stock opts to do nothing when his opponent's on the ledge. I usually see Wolves like Ralphie and other Wolves just use down tilt quite frequently to just like poke out some kind of unsafe option.
Yo, is that
That's going to be the tipper back here, and that
no
will be a
way!
Game for Stock Taker.
Yo!
That early lead really, really paid its dividends for him after that very first stock, and he was just able to trade blows. That's what you want to do on Mario, honestly. Once... It's kind of similar to playing against Sheik in Smash 4, where if you're up, you want to keep trading. You're going to mostly be trading with Mario because he has lots of quick aerials to just deploy immediately. Nair being one of them, very primarily. So you're going to want to keep trading. And Wolf has more enough in the arsenal to trade with a lot of Mario's moves.
Yep. Not only was he trading, but because of... I wouldn't necessarily call it passive play, but he was playing back. And that combined with that is, reactive is a better word.
Yeah, I'd say it's reactive. He was passive playing, reactive, I guess I'd call it.
Yeah, more of a war of attrition. And even though Anti was able to close much of the gap, he still managed to close it out because he wasn't getting all this extra percent on him when he didn't need to.
I think his early discipline as a villager player actually helps him, like, whittle his opponents down a little bit. He knows he's not going to be... Like, Stock Taker isn't one to be netting any crazy, crazy quick stocks. So he's really able to, like you said, a war of attrition. His opponent pretty much just whittle them down until, you know, he's the victor.
Absolutely. And that, I feel like that comes generally from zoners when you have the experience, is that even if your character is capable of rushdown, Wolf absolutely capable of playing at a distance. He didn't use his jump, did he? He's dead.
No, he's burned his jump anti-sniping that stock away. Yeah, Stock Taker's going to have to be watching these jumps because the fireball comes in at such an arc that it's going to peg you almost every time you're diagonally below the stage.
And Wolf likes to keep it a little bit ambiguous with his side B or his up B, both of them having a delay, and if he makes it obvious which one he's going for, that's an easier punish for him. So trying to get that diagonal space where he can keep it ambiguous is going to be hard with Mario's fireball.
One thing that Anti's been doing a great job of is not jumping in front of Stock Taker too much, especially when cornered to the ledge. Wolf will be snuffing out that jump every single time with back air if he can.
Mm-hmm. All right. Dodge right there.
I love also the lack of commitment from Stock Taker after he F-tilts. He just runs away.
Mm-hmm. Now, see, the thing is, that was a good option, but he got chased right there and lost the whole stage for it, which is the thing. He's got to make sure that he keeps his aggression in check just enough so that he threatens it. Otherwise, he'll get tossed off.
Wow, living great DI by Anti. Ooh! Oh, but the Nair actually tanking through
not only
fireball and extending the hitbox. That was wild.
Not only extending it, but extending his place in the air, keeping him held right up there for Mario to land into. All right,
that was a great jump over. Anti getting a little overzealous with that F smash there. I think he just wanted stage control. Okay, try to two frame right there.
Cool. Yeah, he's a good call out on the fireball.
Stock Taker has been managing his real estate super, super well this entire set. He's just been hanging in there and keeping a nice little air of effect around him that Anti just can't seem to penetrate.
All right, good job with the rising air. Chases that. Oh, good down smash. That's bad. Oh, okay, he gets back.
So I like how Stock's also been opting for the up B over the side B more often. It's definitely a more safe recovery tool for Wolf, because if Wolf gets caught screwing up on that linear recovery, he's going to get destroyed.
Yes, absolutely. At least you can mess with the line a little bit, make it a little bit less obvious where you're going.
Okay, yeah, both of them are now just hunting for their win conditions right here.
Yep. Nice! That was really good. So he had Landed with the back air. Very low recovery on that one. I don't think it had an auto-cancel, but he didn't need it regardless. Goes for the down smash right after. And that would have low-profiled a lot of options that Wolf wants out of that. Like, oh, I'm going to hop out of shield forward air. Back air. I'm going to hop out of shield there for safety. So not too risky of an option to go for.
Anti's DI, Stocktaker's DI off of these up throws has been immaculate. He's not been getting early combo. Okay, great job saving the jump to the last moment and not poking above the ledge right there. This is big for Stocktaker. I like how Anti's been catching Stocktaker's landings a lot.
Yes, he's been doing a really good job. And that's the advantage that he needs
absolutely.
Because he doesn't get too many chances.
Okay. This is going to be some nice damage right there. I call Mario's down air the baseball mitt. Because that thing catches everything.
Yo, absolutely. Very active, very large hitbox. All right.
All right, pop in the quick nooch.
Oh.
Oh, wow, he
parried
it.
Yep. No punish off of that because it snaps to the ledge, but sending a message. Oh, never mind!
That was so, if that was pre-patched, I would have killed.
Oh, my God.
That was so scary.
Yeah,
oh, that's
dead.
Crazy.
He's absolutely dead.
Stocktaker going up 2-1 on Anti. He's been catching these landings every single time. Anti's been kind of drifting into him. He's got to realize that he can't keep landing on Wolf or else he's going to get stuffed out.
So can I tell you something interesting about Wolf's down smash?
Let's hear it.
That nerf?
Let's hear it.
Wolf's down smash actually got nerfed at lower percents, but it kills slightly earlier at the ledge and
really?
Stage at higher.
Actually.
So it got a change. It's
a
not
change.
A nerf because parts of it are buff.
It's in the middle.
Yes.
Put
so,
a dash there.
Regardless, catching two smashes right there to take it out on game three. Going into game four, we'll see if Anti can't figure out what he needs to do here. Because he's making it work in the neutral. The conversions when he gets in is making it work. But Wolf just has a lot more options to explosively take stocks, I think.
So going to triplats right here. Definitely agree with this counter pick for Anti. The triplats really aid Mario in being able to rack up a ton of damage. And if we know one thing about Anti, given his legacy, is that he is a master of using those platforms to rack up insane amounts of damage.
Mm-hmm. Not only that, see, I don't know how much this would come into play, but that little tilt at the edge by the ledge actually comes into effect for a lot of people with projectiles, especially Mario. So I wonder if he might use that to get some weird angles that
Stockinger
is not expecting. But I don't know. He would
very
know
interesting point that you make, actually, because I could see that actually being a great...
Oh.
Okay, cool.
No, very nice recovery. Very patient, too.
Wow, that was the quickest back air I've ever seen in my life. All right, just waiting. Yeah, this stage actually isn't too crazy for Stocktaker, I guess, because the slant actually helps him whiff punish these get-ups. Wow. I shouldn't say whiff punish. I just say punish these get-ups with that back air. Yeah, he's not whiffing anything. He's just trying to get on the stage.
Hold on. All right.
Anti, though.
Trying to chase.
Very, very early lead taken from Anti right here. And this is just additional extra credit now for Anti.
Yep. And you see
oh, my God. That's
oh
a death.
No.
That's a death.
No. Oh, my God.
Oh, my
this
God.
Is, oh, this is really difficult now. This
yeah,
is
dude.
Actually absurdly hard to get back from.
Speak of the triplats and they shall appear.
Oh, no. Chases off
oh,
the air
the
dodge.
Oh, the trip off the nair. That was so
please,
amazing.
No.
That was so unfortunate for Stocktaker.
I mean, this would be the kind of momentum that Anti needs to take into Game 5 if he wants to take this away. And he's kind of running away with this right now. He has all the momentum.
So, sorry. Oh, never mind.
All right, there you go. That's, oh, wow, he's still living. All right, just check. Just knock him off the stage, but Mario with the sword of lead. You see him
he's
trading
living.
Hits like that.
For so long. Stocktaker desperately trying to claw this lead back, but he's still staying reserved. He's still keeping his area of effect and staying in the same zone. He's not approaching too viciously, I should say, on Anti.
And
he knows if he gets grabbed once, he's going to explode.
Ooh.
Look at Wolf's face.
Whoa!
He's like, whoa!
Neutral getup was a mistake.
I wonder if the slants affect neutral getup in any sort of negative way.
Here's the thing. What I was curious about, I feel like it wouldn't
does
particularly.
Does that affect the timing at
but,
all? I'm wondering.
But
does it make it easier?
I wonder if it changes roll distance at all. Because we saw Anti did the up smash.
Right.
Because of the angle, if it shortens that, and it means that he can cover a roll-in with the up smash like that, because it's got such a good reverse hitbox.
Right.
Because he hadn't turned it around. He was just doing it right at the ledge there. All right, going into...
What stage are we going to?
Solid question. We'll see. All right. So...
Town and City, okay.
Town and City, yep.
So this will be interesting. Anti won't be able to kill off the top as easily, but the platforms will help him navigate a bit. The thing is, I think Wolf likes more real estate typically to work with.
Yes. One big thing, and I say this because this is like a big
wow.
factor, in that people die off the side a lot earlier here, and Wolf really likes to kill off the side. Forward smash, down smash, forward tilt, two frames, especially two frames, although he hasn't really landed too many.
I just want to note that adaptation from Anti real quick. Earlier, he did a double jab onto Stock Taker's shield, and every single time, Stock was able to shield grab it, but he made sure to delay it early enough to where he was able to get the spot dodge immediately after it. So you can show that Anti's really, really been picking up on every single habit that Stock Taker's been doing.
Yes. Tries to go for that cape. I guess that's a sort of like Trump tech that he's going for there.
What the pivot up smash?
Yo, Anti popping his head a little bit. He's like, oh yeah, I'm feeling it. I'm ready.
Yeah, this is a big momentum shift right here in the entire set, really. That last game was really a statement for Anti.
Yes, that was a big momentum thing mentally. Coming off of that game, you've got to be feeling yourself a little bit. And feeling yourself is something that I think he might need right now.
Anti's a very momentum-based player as well. I feel like he rides the momentum really, really well. And Stock Taker hasn't been doing too much to mitigate the momentum thus far. Like, this is pretty much just free trade damage for both Stock Taker and Anti, but Anti's going to be getting the better of it, obviously, because he's on the stock.
Absolutely. Nice.
All right, there we go, though. That back air is coming out mad quick. That's how he's been seeing most of these stocks.
Yes. Yeah, the stocks have been pretty even. I mean, when a game is not being run away from, but
That platform was like, yo, what's good, fam? I'm going to help you out real quick.
Yo, it's all part of the script, man. We got it all written down right here.
It's like enter stage left. Enter stage right, I should say.
Yeah, enter stage right. Platform, death off the top. What do you mean he didn't die off the top?
Wow, he didn't get the sweet spot off that down smash. So unfortunate for him.
All right, nice. Bates with the forward smash and then goes for the anti-air.
Really all smart usage of that up air there with the back hit to kind of arc over where Anti was about to go. This is anyone's stock right now.
Oh!
All right. Wow. Okay. Not opting to punish that F smash right there. He realized he didn't have enough time to do anything substantial.
Yep. Both of those characters actually with kind of fast for the move.
One thing I want to see.
Yo, he put the reflector down too early. That could have been really bad.
One thing I'm worried about for Stock Taker is that he himself has described himself as a player with no patience.
Yes.
So it really at this is going to be a crucial swing in the entire game right here.
Yes.
It's just about who's going to have more patience and punish someone for doing the dumb thing first.
I think the one who gets the first stock here, the one who takes the stock first, if the other stock is not taken immediately, I think they will have it just based off the momentum.
And
we'll
Stock Taker takes it. This is going to be a massive win for Stock Taker.
All right.
There we go.
Right.
Even Steven.
Even footing. Even
here
footing.
We go.
It's anybody's game. This is close as we can get. Game 5.
All right.
Right, dash attack follow-up goes for a read. This is going to be a lot of damage.
Yeah, absolutely. If he can't land. Okay, land. Wolf's aerial drift is actually not that terrible at all, so he can kind of just pop an air to cover his landing. If he followed up with a dare, that could have been it.
Oh, he gets caught on the fireball. That extends his hurtbox out there to actually make him more punishable.
The dash attack putting him in the corner.
Oh, this is not good.
Anti cannot regain center stage control if Stock Taker is going to win this. The year's coming out. New York supporting their boy, even though Anti's New York too.
Yep.
That was a great roll away. Anti's just pressing buttons right now.
Anti does not want to get hit right here. A straight hit can do it from Wolf right now. All right.
One F smash.
Yep. We see the hose
either.
Out, trying to get some stage control right there. Whips the forward smash to try to bait something in.
Almost catching that air dodge. Ooh. Oh my god, the fireball!
Yep. You saw the startup for the smash right there.
Throw. Forward throw. Okay.
Tech chases.
That should be it.
No, he's living. And with a lot of rage, too.
One more F tilt on the get up. Oh, we tried to get it, but that's all.
No, he falls out.
No way. Oh, my gosh. That's the dash attack.
That's
going to be it. Stock Taker takes it over
Anti.
3-2.
Taking it over Anti.
Set Taker.